Author Judy Blume is one of the leading critics of banning books. Her powerful books, many dealing with growing up and making sense of adolescence, mean a lot to a lot of people. Ground zero for her fight and for many is her home state of Florida because of legislation backed by Governor Ron DeSantis and the Republican-controlled state legislature. As we've been reporting on the program, the criteria for pulling books off shelves of Florida schools is not clear often, and there's been a lot of anger over the move. One Florida school district removed Blume's book Forever from shelves, and her novels have faced bans and challenges for decades because they often dive into puberty and sex. The new documentary, Judy Blume Forever, on Amazon Prime, dives more into her story. And in theaters today is the movie Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret, based on her best-selling book with the same title, first published in 1970. The iconic author, Judy Blume, joins me tonight. Ms. Blume, it is such a pleasure to meet you. You've had such an impact on so many generations of people. I remember when Forever came out, it blew my mind when I was a kid. You faced people trying to ban your books from a long time ago. Did you ever imagine you would still be facing these kind of attacks in 2023?
Never. Never, never, never. And of course, it's not just me. It's a whole lot of people who are facing the attacks today. It's much worse.
It is worse in what way?
It's worse because it's coming from the government. You know, I mean, I happen to live in Key West, which we pretend isn't in that state where we have that governor, but in fact it is, and we do. And, you know, we have elected legislators who are trying to not just ban books, but, you know, control what kids can learn, what they can ask, what they can think. I mean, it's that bad. And it's not just in Florida. It's in a lot of states.
When you look at the current crop of particularly of books that are being targeted, and I mean, you know, your books are still being targeted, they often deal with matters of race, gender identity, sexuality. Do you see, is that the same topics that were being attempted to be banned back in the 80s, let's say?
Well, you know, sexuality is always so dangerous for anybody. Puberty is such a dirty word to some people. So that's the same. But what's different is that, you know, any books, LGBTQ, any books having to do with gender, any books having to do with racism. And what's really scary to me is that it's as if the book banners want to get rid of history. They just want to erase history. That's scary stuff.
It's also interesting to me because when you actually kind of drill down on some of the people who are doing this, you realize they actually haven't read these books. It's not like they've actually read them and are personally outraged by them. They've often been, you know, they've downloaded lists of books that are supposedly dangerous from some organization online who just prints out lists of books that they think should be banned, and people go to school boards and raise hell about these books. They haven't read them.
Exactly, but they never did read them. They didn't read them in the 80s either. It's based on fear. I've always thought it was based on fear, and it's based on how can we control? We want to control our children's lives. How are we going to do that? It's worse and worse now with the internet. How can we control it? Oh, I know. We can take away books. Mm. Not guns, but books.
Can you talk a little bit about the way you approached writing from the beginning? I mean, why you chose to write books that dealt candidly with real issues facing young people? I mean, even actually me asking that question sounds so stupid because it seems like such an obvious thing. Of course, you're an author, you would want to write books that dealt with real issues facing young people. But what there weren't a lot of people doing it when you started.
I just knew that I wanted to write books about real kids in the real world. That was my real world, you know, not everybody's. And I hated secrets. God, I hated secrets, family secrets, any secrets when I was a kid. And so I wanted to be honest and truthful. Hmm. I didn't know anything more than that.
There's a lovely Amazon documentary, I think it came, started streaming last week, about your life and your work. It's called Judy Blume Forever. And it, one of the things that's just so amazing in this, and we're showing some of the video right now, is that you have had not only the impact you've had on the lives of adolescents in this country for generations, but people, so many young people reached out to you and you wrote them back. And in some cases, you have had correspondence back and forth with people for decades. And some of those young people who wrote to you are now authors themselves, which is, I mean, that's incredible.
Yes, and in the documentary, you meet two of the now women who have children themselves who are teenagers or beyond, who wrote to me. One started when she was 9 and one when she was 12. And we have never lost touch.
I mean, what an incredible family to have built. I mean, an extended family of readers and admirers and people who become strangers who become friends.
Yep. I never think of it that way, but that's lovely. Thank you.
So tonight is the opening of Are You There, God? It's Me, Margaret. You waited 53 years to make this film. Why so long?
I don't know. I was afraid. I thought it would get ruined. Although a book is a book and a movie is a movie, but it wasn't until this team came along, and I just knew it was the right team, and it turned out to be absolutely the right team.